So here's the web page where you can find the next program I'd like to use or to show you that will let you explore the Hénon attractor. This page is not on the Complexity Explorer site. It's at the CNRS site in France. And accordingly, it's in French, but I don't think you'll need to read any French to understand what's on the page. Up here is just a little bit of history of the Hénon map and the Hénon attractor. You can use Google Translate to turn that into English or any other language if you want. But if you scroll down the page, you get to the JavaScript program here, and this is what I want to focus on. So, as before on the program on Complexity Explorer, you can choose A and B, and then it will plot the attractor for you. So it defaults to the standard values, 1.4, 0.3, that's what Michel Hénon studied originally. And we see again this attractor shape, this bend, curve, U sort of shape. So if you click on this, you can zoom in, and every time you click, it zooms in by a factor of 4. So let's see what's going on in here, this region that appears solid. So we zoomed in, and something to note is that when we do that, you can see that the individual dots being plotted, and they're being plotted in the order that they arise in iteration. So you can see, and I said this before, and maybe this is obvious if you looked at the time series plots, but that this complex geometric shape, which is smooth, is made by points that bounce around. So it's not the case that the orbit slides along this way, like we saw, say, for the Lotka-Volterra equation, lines in phase space. Here in this xy plane, there are dots that jump around. And so I'll zoom in again, and you can see that individual dots appearing on the screen. I'll zoom in once more. And now, since we're looking at such a small piece of the large shape, you can see this phenomena of points being kind of filled in one at a time. Clearly, the orbit is not sliding up and down these lines. Okay, so that's one point. The map, the functions are making the shape by bouncing the points around. All right, so another thing to notice, which you've probably already noticed, is that this is a fractal. That one sees, anytime you see a solid line, if you zoom in on it, it actually turns into two lines. Or perhaps, you know, four lines or eight lines. So, this structure is something that's folded over on itself again and again and again and again, like a pastry dough or something like that. And so anytime you think you have a single flake of dough or flake of the attractor, if you zoom in, you actually realize that that wasn't one flake, that actually is two flakes. And those two flakes each are made up of two flakes and so on. So we zoom in more and more, and we keep seeing this structure where single lines turn into two lines. I'm zoomed in many, many times now. I've lost track of how many times. But we still see that there is some structure here. You zoom in more and more, and there continues to be this sort of structure. All right, let me zoom back out. You can do that by clicking here. And there's the full attractor again. We were zoomed way in somewhere over here. Now let me zoom in over here a couple times just for fun. You can see the shape is bent within itself again and again. You can see more and more of those bends. Right, you can see here this is looks like it's actually two lines, not one. That's double, also not single. So there's an incredibly intricate structure to this shape. The motion on it is chaotic, but it's an attractor because orbits are pulled towards it. All right, so you can explore and zoom in on different regions and play around with this. The last thing I want to show you on this program is taking a look at different parameter values. So let me go back here And you can change the parameter values with this slider bar or by typing in. And I'm just going to type in, I'm going to go 0.8, and then I hit enter. And that was the example we started this subunit with. This was the periodic example, period 2. There's one point, and there's another point. So this must have been the one that was about 1.2 and minus 0.1 or something. They're different scales on the x and y axes. So just seeing again this sort of period 2 behavior. Let me take a slider bar, let's see, move it down to 0.1. And then I can step things up by 0.1 at a time. So here we're seeing just a single fixed point. We're at 0.1. And I'm going to increase, so I'm increasing A by just hitting the right arrow key on my keyboard. And notice that the single fixed point is moving, but it's still one single fixed point. Similar to what we saw in the logistic equation. We have a fixed point, but that fixed point moves around, increasing. And there we have period 2. So there's period 1, and there's period 2. And at the transition, one sees a little bit of smudging or smearing, just like we did in the bifurcation diagram for the logistic equation. I'll increase it more. Sometimes it runs off the screen here, but it's going to come back. All right, there, they're both back now. Period 2, this is 0.8. That's the one we studied before. Increasing it more, we're going to see this turn into period 4. There it is. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's going to split. This is period doubling again. One could calculate the A values at which this occur, and it would agree with Feigenbaum's number. There's period 8. And then we can't really resolve period 16. It splits into some chaotic region, some chaotic behavior. And strange attractors all along here. The shapes are a little different. Increasing up. Uh-oh. Now we're in a periodic window. This looks like period 5, I think. Maybe it's period 6, or maybe that's a smudge on my monitor. I can't tell, but it looks period 5. Oh, no. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's period 7. 1.25 is period 7. So that's a period 7 window. That doubles, and then back to chaos. And we can increase our way up to 1.4. So one can form a bifurcation diagram for a system like this. One has to either do a really complicated 3D plot that's difficult to visualize, or restrict oneself to just plotting either the x final states or the y final states. In any event, this program I think is pretty easy to use. It's easy to experiment with different parameter values. It's easy to zoom in. So this can be a fun tool to explore the Hénon map a little bit further. So we've seen our first example of a strange attractor. The attractor for the Hénon map with the standard values 1.4 and 0.3, and for that matter many other values, has a strange attractor. That's that sideways U structure that's folded over itself again and again and again. So let me just underscore what a strange attractor is. So a strange attractor, first of all, is an attractor. So that means that almost all orbits are going to get pulled into that attractor. We'll see that general shape being made no matter what our initial conditions are. And remember that attracting behavior is stable, stuff that we would expect to observe. The strange part is that the behavior on the attractor is not periodic, but chaotic. So it has sensitive dependence on initial conditions and is aperiodic. It stays on the attractor, on that U-shaped thing, bouncing around, but the motion is aperiodic and it has sensitive dependence on initial conditions. And it's chaotic because it's a deterministic system and the orbits are clearly bounded. So this is a form of stable, chaotic behavior. So the strange attractor sort of is a merging of what one might have formerly thought to be opposites. It's a predictable shape. No matter what the initial condition is, we're going to see that shape. but the motion on the attractor is unpredictable, strongly unpredictable in the sense of the butterfly effect. It is unstable in the sense that, again, it has a butterfly effect. So unstable, meaning if we have two initial conditions that start very close, they get pushed apart very quickly. Butterfly effect is indicates a certain type of instability. On the other hand, it's stable because even though they get pushed apart, they're going to stay on the attractor. If an external influence comes and pulls something off the attractor, it'll get pulled to it very quickly, and then it will continue moving on the attractor in a chaotic and unpredictable fashion. So strange attractors combine order and disorder, predictability and unpredictability. Another thing I just want to highlight for you about the example we just did is that the Hénon attractor is, some ways of looking at it, a very complex shape. It's this sideways U that's folded over itself again and again and again. Nevertheless, that complex or complicated shape is made by a very, very simple iterated function. Again, it's just a parabola. One of the functions is linear, the other function is a parabola, and it's able to make that incredibly complicated shape. So again, we see that simple systems, when iterated, when put in that feedback loop, are capable of producing outcome with surprising complexity. In the next subunit, we'll see that not only iterated maps have strange attractors, but differential equations can have strange attractors too. And the example we'll use is the Lorentz equations.